the one thing we've always had at RCR, we've always had to change with the time, going from the 70s with me to the 80s and the mid-80s with Dale and Ricky Rudd in the early 80s, and we just had to keep changing with times. One of the biggest things that happened, I think you go back to the days that R.J. Reynolds got in the sport and helped carry us all to another level. I think if you look at some of the major corporations that was in our sport in the 90s, the Goodrichs, the DuPonts, the major corporation Kellogg's, you can go on and on about the major companies that got in, Fortune 500 companies. And when you've seen that, it just kept getting bigger and bigger. And the racing, I think the racing was the best in the 90s. Today, the racing, I think, is even better than it was in our prime time. And it's showing this year. But I think just our product, the racing on the racetrack, the talent that we had some great, great stars with Dale and Jeff Gordon coming in, was a whole new era, and he brought in a whole new different group of fans. And so that's, you could see the change, and we just had to make changes along the way with it. I never looked at he and Jeff as a rivalry. I looked at two guys that were hard competitors and wanted to win. One was a young, up-and-coming superstar he ended up being, and here you had a guy that was getting older as the time goes. So they did clash, everything from toasting with a cup of milk to the mustache to so many things, but I think both of them had a tremendous amount of respect for each other's ability. First off, Bill France Jr. talked to me and said, look, I really need you to get in this truck series. We need another guy that can go out there and build a brand around this truck series. And he said, we need you to do it. And so I knew Skinner. I'd watched him race, and he was a really aggressive race driver, and he was a winning race driver. And I thought he would really be good to put in the car, and he was a good choice. We won the championship that year and won quite a few races. So we did what France wanted me to, and you know, Mike was a rugged, tough old race driver. Yeah, it was a challenge at times, mostly with personalities, not as much as a distraction. We never looked at it as a distraction. We looked at it as a goal to try to help us win more and win races. I told him if he went out and did good and I started a second team, I would hire him as a driver. And I had opportunities to hire other veterans, but I told Mike that, and I wanted to keep my word, and I kept my word, and he came in there, and we should have won a lot of races with him. He's led a lot of races for us back in the day, but we couldn't never, well, we won Japan, but we couldn't never get that win put together that we were looking for. I've got so many stories around that trips to Japan, from testing to racing to Dale Jr. and Senior, and Mike Skinner winning, and Mike, I think that's where one of the very first burnouts came from was Mike Skinner did the big burnout over there in Suzuka or wherever we were at. It was so much fun to go over there. It was hard and it was drooling and long, but we really enjoyed it. It was a fun trip. Yeah, the two-car team deal, you know, if I had it to do over, all of us would have stuck with one car, but when Junior Johnson brought out two cars in the 80s, and other teams started bringing out two cars, and Wrangler was sponsoring two, and we seen the trend going to two teams and maybe even three and finally four. I think that if you didn't change with the time, it just helped your revenue stream and it helped divide some of the cost over all of your overhead. Going into Talladega, we were leading the points and we had done really well, and I think we'd won a race or two in 97. But once he got hurt at Talladega, and we just never, I think we changed crew chiefs along that era. I think that at that time, we didn't have the cars that he needed. We couldn't get him comfortable in the car like he needed to be. And it was a couple of tough years, but we did win the Daytona 500 in 98. Well, it was special because I knew what it meant to Dale's resume to have the Daytona 500. That's what he wanted so bad. He had won, 11 or 12 of the 125s and 150s back in the day. And I rocked the back then, the Busch series. He had won everything, and we won the Daytona 499 two or three times. But to get to 598, I knew how special it was to him more than anything, and to see all of the crew members come out there on pit road and stand and congratulate him. Everybody in that garage knew how close we had came, but to finally pull it off, it was a big deal. But I felt more relieved because we did it with Dale, and I knew how important it was. And we'd let him down a couple of times. We'd ran out of gas once, we blew a tire once, and on the last laps of the race, and we had a dominant car when we ran out of fuel. And I remember when I was spraying ether in the carburetor, it blew the engine. So it was a tough year. We had a lot of things. Dale was injured, didn't have him the cars he needed at the point in his career. You know, Dale had talked to me about it. He had ran other stuff before, Xfinity and some different things with different drivers, the truck series. And he had me come over one day and showed me this big field, and all was in it. He had drilled a well. And he said, hey, we was riding around in an old pickup truck out there, and his old farm truck. And he said, here's what I want to do. We just pulled up there and stopped. He said, I want to build a cup team, but I'll always drive for you. I'll never drive for this team. He said, like I told you, I started with you, I'm gonna finish with you. And so we sat there and looked at that whole area where he built DEI. And we talked many, many, many phone conversations and conversations about different things about cup racing from the owner's standpoint. And he would call me a lot of times at night and say, hey, I know you're having that last glass of wine. Let's talk a minute. So that's how our relationship was. And I wasn't worried about it. I tried to help him every way I could to make sure that DEI was successful as well. Dale could always amaze you at Daytona and Talladega. And I know he wanted to pit. We were running in the top four or five, six up there. And he said, I want four tires. I said, no, Dale, let's don't give up your track position. He says, no, he said, I need four tires. I said, let's keep our track position. You'll have a shot of winning this thing. Skinner was leading the race, I think, at the time. And he's come around, and he all of a sudden said, I'm on pit road. So we gave him four tires. He went out and won the race. He put on a great performance that day. We just thought that was one more step to winning the championship in 2000. We finished second to, I think it was Bobby Labonte. And we finished second in the points that year, and by just missed it by a few. And so we knew going into 2001 that that was going to be our year to win his eighth championship, seven for us and eight for him. You know, I knew Kevin was going to be a great race driver, and he is today. You know, I watched him race the truck. And I watched him beat his best friend up one time out in California on a racetrack. Was Ron Hornaday, and he beat on him. And I knew then he was the type of driver I wanted. And I watched him in the truck. He actually rammed old Johnny Sauter, I think at the time it was driving for us. And I said, that's my kind of driver right there. And at the time we had Kevin doing a lot of testing for Dale, and he was running our Xfinity car. And I knew that just watching him drive a cup car, that's the reason I knew Kevin Harvick could go out and do the job for us. You know, you go back to 2001 when we lost Dale in Daytona. That was a turning moment for RCR. You know, we didn't know what we wanted to do, myself personally, if I wanted to get out of the sport. At that time, I was going to, and then I decided we had this great young driver, Kevin Harvick. He's the only person, even in today's world out there, that I think could have came in and did the job he did with the pressure he was under to get in Dale Earnhardt's car and go out and race it. I remember in Daytona, I called Bobby Hutches, and after I made up my decision to go go to Rockingham, I said, Bobby, call NASCAR, get the lowest number you can. It happened to be number 29. And I said, paint the car white, call Kevin Harvick and have him at my office tonight. I'll be in there. We got in about 10 o'clock at Tuesday or Wednesday, and that's when we put our deal with Kevin. And I knew, I just watching him race his first race at Daytona in a, back then, a Busch car, I knew he was going to be a champion. You know, I think Atlanta in 2001, after we had lost Dale, and Rockingham with Steve Park winning the race, us coming back and winning the race with Kevin, almost a mirror finish like Dale and Bobby Labonte and then Kevin and Jeff Gordon. To win that race, it was a healing moment. There was healing moments in the whole sport after losing our hero was Dale Earnhardt. And I think one of them was Steve Park winning, Kevin winning in Atlanta in 2001, Dale Jr. win July the 4th. I think those are the key healing moments of the sport. And 2001, Kevin winning in Atlanta, it kind of made RCR feel better. You'd never feel better about losing Dale, but it made us feel better that we made the right decision to go on. Dale Earnhardt, he and I had several conversations, and our conversation was if something happened to either one of us, we had to go on. I think the first year, it was we were running on the emotion of the sport, and the following year with Kevin, we didn't do him a good job. We were all struggling at that point. But after that, we kind of put it together, had a better combination of people, had better cars. We gave him the cars he needed to go out and win with. And it just took some time for us to gel back after he had been with Dale for almost 20 years. And then bringing Kevin in, it wasn't a matter of him fitting in. It was a matter of us getting what he needed to go out and win races with. I think the biggest thing was just meshing all of us together and getting Kevin what he needed in the car. He was different than Dale. All drivers are different, but making sure that we could put under him what he needed to go out and win races. And we struggled. We got a little off on our engines for a little stretch there, but I think it started coming together in 4 and 5. We went through so much pain and struggle in 2001, and for Kevin to come back and win that championship at Homestead, I'll never forget the emotion that was in all of us, and it was another one of those healing moments for RCR at that point, because we knew at that time that we'd went on and made the right decision. It was a big deal for RCR to be able to go out and win championships in the truck with Mike Skinner, with Kevin in Xfinity. We went on to win other championships and to win championships with Dale. It was a good accomplishment for our organization at the time, and I don't think anyone's done it since.